Welcome to Tribe Core. My name's Allison, and this is Alex. Also a coach who's going to be doing the workout with us today. So we're going to jump in to the warm-up. So we're going to start with 30 seconds of those posterior lunges. So let me get our timer ready. Okay. Starting in 3, 2, 1, and go with those posterior lunges. Sit up nice and tall. Stepping back. Shoulders down, away from the ears. We're going to go through these exercises for 30 seconds each, okay? Halfway through. After this, we're going to go into hinge twists. If you remember, jump in. If you don't, just take a second and we'll show you. Walk through it. 3, 2, 1, and switch. So, nice light bend in those knees. You're going to anchor that hand and open up. Anchor that hand. Have your eyes follow that hand. Nice mobility movement prep exercise. Opening up through that chest. Nice. After this, we're going to go into pike planks. 3, 2, 1, and switch. So, go in that plank position. Bend the sitting up in those hips. Push those heels down to the floor. And coming back. If you want, you can add a tap. You tap that shin and knee, foot, whatever your range is. Good job, y'all. After this, you're going to go into lateral squats. You have the room, you can move with it. If not, no worries. 3, 2, 1, and switch. So lateral squats. We're going to stay in place. That way we don't shuffle off camera. The chest up. Hands overhead. After this, we're going into prone raises in 3, 2, 1, and switch. If you have weights, feel free. If not, no worries. Bring your opposite arm, opposite leg up, and switch sides. So alternate. If you want, you can add weights in it. This is a warm up, so no worries. If not, after this, we're going into Everest steps. 3, 2, 1, and switch. So feel free, watch out. So I'm getting ready. Plank position. Bring that foot up and back. If you need to, you can bring it here. Bring it here, wherever your range is. Halfway through, and we're gonna go back to the top. The posterior lunges. Nice. 3, 2, 1, and switch. Going to the top, posterior lunges. Halfway through this.
Nice and tight.
squeezing those glutes as you bring that foot up in the back. You don't need to raise it up too high. You don't want to have it sink into your low back. After this, we're going to go to lateral squats in 3, 2, 1, and switch. Nice work, team. So hopefully you guys are feeling warm. So for today's workout, the training objective is to use an ascending and descending volume formula designed to continue focusing on muscles that support the function of the spine along with muscles that stabilize the hips and shoulders. So for the formula, there are 6 stations with 3 formulas. Station 1, you're going to perform 25 seconds of dumbbell single deadlift row. So half on the left, half on the right. Followed by 5 seconds rest, then 25 seconds of Everest steps, followed by 5 seconds rest, then 25 seconds of posterior lunges, followed by 5 seconds rest. Then doing that all 3 times, you'll allow 30 seconds rest and advance to station 2. So station 2 shares the same formula as station 1, using different exercises, time frame, and rest period. And you'll be doing that for 2 times through. Allow 30 seconds rest and advance to station 3. Station 3, you're going to perform 60 seconds of each exercise listed twice. Allow 60 seconds rest, advance to station 4. Station 4, 5, and 6. All those stations share the same exercises as stations 1, 2, and 3, respectively. This time, however, the formulas are in reverse. Allow 30 seconds rest between each station. Once the stations are complete, move straight to the mobility sequence. Now let's look at the 2 new exercises for today, toe taps and split presses.
Toe taps. The exercise is going to look like this. So for the toe taps, the main benefit is strengthening through that interior core as well as hip stability. So for this, the start position is going to be laying on your back, palms facing up, and then you're going to bring those feet up, creating a hook position with your feet. You're then going to allow one leg to come down, tapping the floor, and then coming back to that start position, and then allowing yourself to do the same thing on the opposite side. So for this, left and right is 1 repetition. Some common faults for this is excessive lumbar extension, so allowing yourself to leave that neutral position. So you're going to think about bracing through that tummy, keeping that core nice and tight. Also, having those palms down, maybe pushing forward or rolling through the shoulders. So some cues is palms up, engaging through that core nice and tight, nice controlled movement, coming down with that toe tap. The way you can progress and regress this exercise is through load. The split press. The exercise looks like this. So the main benefit of the split press is shoulder mobility and stability, as well as hip mobility and stability, and strengthening through that lateral core. So for this position, you're going to be in that 90-90 lunge, so 90 in the front, 90 in the back. Once you begin, you'll tuck that toe, and you'll have that dumbbell in that front rack position. As you press off that back foot, then driving through the front heel, you're going to be pressing that dumbbell overhead, and then coming back down to that start position. So for the repetition count, here, every time you press overhead is one repetition. However, whatever you do on the left, you must do on the right. And so for the common thoughts for this exercise, internally rotating or bring that knee in, as well as bringing that knee past that front toe. So you make sure you stay up nice, stack, nice long spine. Another common fault is lumbar flexion or extension or raising of the shoulders. So for this one, you wanna make sure that you think about keeping your shoulders back away from the ears, keeping a nice long spine, making sure you keep your hips parallel to the floor. And then for this one, the progression and regression is gonna be the load as well as range of motion.
Okay, guys. Okay, so we're starting with station one. Station one, you're gonna be doing those three exercises. So dumbbell, single deadlift rows, then going into those Everest steps, and then going to posterior lunges. We're gonna be doing 25 seconds on, 5 seconds of rest. 5 seconds of rest isn't that long. It's really 5 seconds of, now let's switch to the next exercise, roll shoulders back and begin. So this one will be a quick transition, especially for those single deadlift rows. We're gonna do about 12-ish seconds on the left and right, give or take. So it's gonna be quick. You might get one or two reps in, no worries. We're aware of that. You guys got this, okay? So we're gonna start to get this all set up. So grab that dumbbell, stand nice and tall, and 3, 2, 1, and go. Woo. Our dumbbell runs. One and switch sides. That's quick. Three, two, one, and rest. Going into those Everest steps, so start getting set up for that. And 3, 2, 1, and go. So you kind of quick. Kind of just slow moving to your next exercise. Not really a long rest. Nice to catch your breath though. That's one round through. We got two more. So for this next round, I'm just going to say 3, 2, 1, and rest. Kind of pause for a second. 3, 2, 1, and go. So now you guys kind of got the hang of it, okay? Three, two, one, and rest. Going into dumbbell single deadlift rows. 3, 2, 1, and go. Remember, this one's short, so we switch in between. Three, two, one, and switch sides. And rest. Going to Everest steps. 3, 2, 1, and go. Rest. After this, we're going to this Everest steps. 3, two, one, and go. Woo! That's two exercises. Rotation one. Jumping in strong. And rest. After this, posterior lunges. Three, two, one, and go.
Last exercise in the station.
Yes. Halfway through. After this, we'll get 30 seconds rest before going to station two. Three, two, one, and rest. Okay, a little rest time to grab some water and grab the stuff you need for station two if needed. Okay, guys, going to station two. So for this one, it's going to be 50 seconds on, 10 seconds off. We're going to be going through that two times through. For this, we're going to start with those toe taps and go to kettlebell swings and then go into the split presses. For those split presses, similar to the double leg rows in station one, it's just gonna be half of the 50 seconds. So we're gonna do 25 seconds and then I'll just tell you to switch and go to the other side, okay? So, let's just get prepped to get to the toe tap. If you have a mat, feel free to use it. So, 50 seconds here. Three, two, one, and go. Keep that core tight. So that there's not really a gap under your back. Your back ball up. Palms facing the ceiling. You don't want to use the floor to help you out. Engage that core. Yeah. Halfway through.
One more time through.
20 seconds left.
Lateral squats. Woo.
30 more seconds of this exercise. Go for it one more time. Station 3 and 4, that time back to back 60 seconds. And that'll just get us over that hill. We got it. Or mountain, 60 seconds. Ooh, it exercises a lot. 10 more seconds. Going back to those traveling planks. 3, 2, 1, and switch. Traveling planks, you got this. Nice controlled steps. We're tight.
Ever steps.
10 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, and switch. Going into those Everest steps.
More seconds. You can do it. Do anything in
15 seconds. Keep it up. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Woo! Okay, 30 seconds rest, then we'll go to station 5. Okay, guys, station 5. So, for this one, it's almost the exact same as station 2. The only difference is now the exercises are flipped, so you're going to still do 50 seconds on, 10 seconds off, 2 times through. Except now we're going to start with those split presses, then we'll go into those kettlebell swings in the middle, but in with the toe taps. And do it one more time. So only tweak to this one. So get your dumbbell ready. Opposite arm and leg in front. 3, 2, 1, and go. The reason I laugh is because I'm pretty sure in station 2 I might have done it wrong. So if you saw it the first time I did it, you know, just ignore it. No worries though. We're all humans, we're all getting better every day. So we're gonna switch it halfway through, a couple more seconds left. 3, 2, 1, and switch arms and legs. Feeling this one. Oh my God. Almost there, we're at 10 seconds rest. 3, 2, 1, and rest. You ready for this kettlebell swings? 3, 2, 1, and go. One station, over halfway done with this workout. Feeling great. Go. halfway through, 25 more seconds. He's got booty. Push that kind of off of those hips. Good. One more exercise after this. Three, two, one, and rest. Get ready for those toe taps. Last one for station five, then only one more station left. Woo! Three, two, one, and go. Pull, trying to pull your leg down to the floor. You got it. Think about all of the strength coming from that core. Focus on that muscle group. We got it. Woo. 20 more seconds. Time's flying. After this, we'll get 30 seconds rest and go to station six. We can do it. Almost there. Three, two, one, and rest. Okay. One more station, guys. One more. Grab some water. We'll get into station six. Okay, guys. Last station of the day, station six. So we're going to start out with those traveling planks and going into those prone raises and lateral squats. We're going to do 25 seconds on, 5 seconds off, just like we did for that first station. So technically 5 seconds of rest. And we'll do that three times through. Just remember, it's going to be quick transitions because that 5 seconds of rest kind of leads into the start of the next exercise. So make sure you have your equipment for prone raises nearby. We're going to start with traveling planks in 3, 2, 1. And go! Last station. Let's get all the energy we got. Just 25 seconds of each. Way better than that 60 seconds, I think. Woo!
Definitely.
Last five. Three, two, one, and rest. Going into those prone raises. In 3, 2, 1, and go.
Go.
3 exercises, and then we are done. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Going back to the traveling plank last time. 3, 2, 1, and go. Focus on trying to keep this one up. This is the last time. Just keep it up in that plank if you can. Only 15 more seconds left. Challenge yourself. You got it. Almost there. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Go into those prone raises. 3, 2, 1, and go. If it's too hard, feel free to take your legs out of it. You need to. Ten more seconds. One more exercise after this. Do pillow forming under on the mat. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Going to those lateral squats. Woo! 3, 2, 1, and go.
Cross rolls. I'm gonna let you down. I'm gonna
job. Good job. Those cross those eyes. I finish up. So do five.
Yes.
Five. Right. For those, bring that foot leg over that front knee so they get nice and tall. Whichever leg you cross over, you're gonna roll towards that side. Then that nice stretch on the outside of that leg. And this is what I'm gonna need to do though, so feel free to continue on going through these or any other stretching or mobility exercises that you need to do. But thank you guys for joining us today, and we will see you next time. Bye guys.